EA Sports, it's in the game. He was like a superhero on that run.
The Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today, rivals square off in the NFC East, and we've got a great matchup between the Washington Commanders and the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This taking in at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football. But that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Field, and he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagle 16. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
All that for a 2-yard gain, second down. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Throwing again on second down. This time
it's a goal. It's been a good opening drive. But you know you don't want to waste it and celebrate a field goal to get to that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
To the air again, Heinicke. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Come up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down. Deron Payne, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
Okay, ready?
Three nothing after 1 on EA Sports. Break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Hurts. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. William Jackson with a pick, and the Commanders are going to take possession of the football. When I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
A give up the middle to Gibson. Though a heck of a man. They'll get this down to the 38.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he's trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. To throw is Heinicke. Throw right side complete to Dotson. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
To throw on 2nd and 10, Heinicke. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
He's a little trigger happy right there. And it turned into the best turn.
Yes, Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Heinicke completes it to Samuel. Touchdown! Curtis Samuel, 30 yards, as his guys are able to extend their lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Joey Sly on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
Here we go.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown, so decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words early on. So we have to decide, do we even need to change game plan, or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Brandon, what's even more impressive is that came against double coverage. He gashed them with that reception, even with the extra focus that he drew from the defense.
Hurts throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
But give them credit for a good read right there, because they read the man coverage on the right side and sent the tight end a few steps down the field and then angled him to the left on a crossing route. He was able to get enough separation on this play to turn it into a nice game.
Off the play fake, here's Hurts rolling to his right. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
It's a second down run with Sanders. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Here we go.
They got to get to the 23 here on third.
18, 5 years.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. 10-0, our score. Extra man here in the secondary for Washington on third down. Here's Hurts to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And all it'll be intercepted. William Jackson with a pick. And the Commanders are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. So they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. They'll go again with Gibson. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. No gain that time, but it's going to leave him with a 3rd and 4 to go. For 4 yards to pick up the first. Third and short yardage. Heinicke. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. across the 30-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Now Heinicke. Complete, it's Dotson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. A couple of first downs on the drive already, as he'll go from the 47 now on first down. Working out of the gun, here's Heinicke. Escaping the pressure right. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now for getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Let's go!
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Heinicke. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Commanders going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They go play action. Now Heinicke. And he will find his man Samuel. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up for the first and goal.
They'll roll him out right. And this is going to be intercepted. Possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. CD, when he went to throw that, I'm not sure if he just didn't see where the defense was. Whatever the case, not the throw you're looking for on first and goal.
Not at all, because look, let's face it, that close to the goal line, if you throw an intercept, it's going to hurt on any down. But really, the only down you can kind of live with is if you do it on fourth down. The first three, if you don't have it wide open, just get rid of it. Make sure they
play. He's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, as the first half is winding down. And the Eagles are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. The PAT good, and we draw them closer, but hold on just a second. A flag is down on the field. So they'll go ahead and accept the penalty. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The clock showing just 16 seconds till the half as they line up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. That's a run to work. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now here's a timeout, as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got not just space, but plenty of room to run.
Rifles is well. That's going to be intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
He's got some space here. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win?
There he goes, offside! Touchdown, Philadelphia! Miles Sanders, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Good with a PAT, and the lead is now 14-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. One-score game, now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth, almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? Looking for the challenge for each side.
Gets hit, and he fumbles it. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
Sense it, and somehow he got to it and was able to recover for the squad.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson will pick. Well, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept a pass to expecting to intercept passes. Their confidence hurt at an all-time high.
Let's go now.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. They'll go again with Sanders, and he carries this one past the midfield stripe and into Commander territory. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and 7 coming up.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
On third down, they turn to Sanders.
About it, and you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. The touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. they're set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. On the tackle, it was the West Virginia man, Kazir White. Well, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back, and just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
Good reactions in defense. That screen was a slow developing, and they shut down the whole game.
In desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Heinicke now from the 50. And his pass is intercepted for the 14 today. And the Eagles are in tight position as they get a 32-yard line.
So rare to see any quarterback toss back-to-back interceptions in the NFL, regardless of status or experience. Whether it's him personally or just the offensive game plan, I think this defense is reading something out there, and they're holding the upper hand.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Throwing is Hurts. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That's good, the completion there for 7 yards. And now we've got a third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Commanders bringing out the nickel package on third down. Hurts sets up to throw it. Blitz coming and down he goes. No surprise there. Chase Young wrecks that play with a sack. The Eagles send out their punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And they'll let this one go right on the outskirts of the 10. They'll down it at the 11-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away, and they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That play ended for a net loss thanks to Javon Hargrave. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him.
Pressure gets there on Heinicke. And down he goes.
Hassan Reddick.
Remember, throughout my career here, defensive coach always say, guys, you get earned the right to rush the passer. They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be solid, and it is pin your ears back time indeed.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Heineke to throw for it on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Second down, back to Sanders. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 6 yards, the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, a positive play for the offense. Try to pick it up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Hurts a handoff to Sanders. We're still about 3 yards shy of the first. Second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.